I seem to recall you telling us the mighty Morn Star was no more, and yet somehow the boy managed to acquire it. Things don't seem to be going according to plan, do they, Shadar?
What you say is true. I went to great lengths to destroy the wand, that the boy might never wield its power. But I could not have known he would travel through time to obtain it.
That reminds me, Lord Garrus. You have used that spell. The one that binds past, present, and future.
Surely not. Surely you did not meet with this savior in the
past. The very thought. What would I stand to gain from such a meeting? Perhaps the good lady forgets that it is Shadar who has been charged with the boy's disposal.
Your excellencies, there is no cause for alarm. Everything is in hand, I assure you. I am the executor charged with bringing destruction to this world, and I fully intend to fulfill my duties.
In any event, the wand he holds is incomplete. Without the power of the three stones, Morn Star is weak. Set against the might of our own wands, it is a mere toy.
It seems you are quite the expert.
They are lost, are they not? The stones from which Morn Star's magic powers sprang.
Correct. The magic stones are lost, but the boy is searching for them now. Of that I have no doubt.
And how are we to stop him finding them?
When the Wizard King concealed them long ago, he entrusted their care to three fearsome guardians. I propose that we awaken the keepers of the stones from their slumber. Does this plan please you, Your Radiance?
It does.
Listen to me well, Shadar. The keepers of the stones shall henceforth answer to you. Use your new powers wisely. The Wizard King's most faithful servants are now yours to command.
Thank you.
Oh.